This is number 20 from the 2003 AMC8, and this is a common question asked, and it says, what is the measure of the acute angle formed by the hands of a clock at 4:20 a.m.? And so when you look at this, first thing you have to do is understand how a clock works. When we talk about a clock, the clock is measured essentially in what we would call mod 12, in that it's broken into 12 parts. And these parts are equally spaced, and so on a circle, they each represent 30 degrees. And so from 1 to 2 is 30 degrees, 2 to 3 is 30 degrees, 3 to 4 is 30 degrees, and so on and so forth. And then we also know that each of the hour marks represent 5 times as many minutes. And so the number of minutes would be 5 minutes and 10 minutes and 15 minutes and 20 minutes and so on and so forth. So at 4:20 a.m., the minute hand, which we'll do in red, is pointed right at the 20-minute mark, so right at the 4. But the hour hand, which we'll do in black, is pointed in between the 4 and 5 because it moves between the 4 and 5 throughout the hour as the minute hand goes all the way around the circle. And so what they're asking for is, what is the measure of this angle right there? And so there's a couple ways to do this. The easiest way for this particular problem is to recognize that we can just consider this piece of our circle. And since from 4 to 5 represents 30 degrees, and 20 minutes is 1/3 of an hour, the hour hand has moved 1/3 from the 4-hour mark to the 5-hour mark. And so the amount of degrees the hour hand has moved from the 4 is 30 times 1/3, which equals 30 times 1/3, which equals 10. And so the correct answer on this problem does turn out to be 10 degrees. And so this right here is the answer. Now, there is another formula that can be helpful in this, and this is a formula that tells you where the angle measure is on the hour hand of a clock. And so if you want to know what the hour hand of a clock in comparison to essentially noon or midnight or whatever you want to think of it, you can use this formula, which is 30 degrees times the number of hours plus 1/2 times the number of minutes. And so in this case, if you want to go with 4:20, the degree measure right here would be 4 times 30, because that's the number of hours, and so that's 120, plus 1/2 the number of minutes, which is 20, so that's 10, and so that gives you 130 degrees. So the angle here is 130 degrees. Since we wanted to know the angle between the hour and the minute, we put the minute right at the 4. Well, we can see easily that that is equal to 120 degrees, and so the difference is our 10 degrees, which is the correct answer on this problem. So this is a nice formula for helping you to find the angle measure in the degrees of the angle measure in the hour hand. The angle measure in the minute hand is always just a fraction of the 360 degrees, however many minutes out of 60 you have. And so if it's the 50th minute, then it's 50 out of 60 times 360 degrees, and so on and so forth.